If you spend much time reading the history portions of the Old Testament, you'll see there were several times in Israel's history when they turned away from God. They turned away from worshiping Him and to the idols of their neighbors. They fell into sinful practices. They refused to follow the law that God had given them. During these times as well, God would use the prophets to warn them that if they did not repent, judgment would come. Well, one time judgment did come in the form of King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon. He defeated Jehoiakim of Judah and hauled many of the people into captivity back to the land of Babylon. Included in those captives were several young men, including Daniel and three of his friends, Hananiah, Azariah, and Mishael. These young men were pressed into Nebuchadnezzar's training program. He wanted to prepare them for service as slaves in the kingdom of Babylon. We read in Daniel chapter 1 that part of that training included eating the king's food. Now, many of these foods were contrary to the laws that God had given Israel. And so we find Daniel, who probably at the time was a teenager, 15, maybe 16 years old, deciding, standing up to Nebuchadnezzar's rulers and trainers and saying, I don't want to defile myself with the king's food. I want to continue to follow the laws that God has given me to live by. I want to read you Daniel chapter 1 verse 8 because the wording of it I think is very interesting and helpful and instructive to us. Daniel 1:8 says, but Daniel resolved that he would not defile himself with the king's food or with the wine that he drank. What I want you to notice is that word resolved. Daniel resolved that he would not eat the king's food. Now, I don't pretend to know all of the details of Daniel being in Babylon and all the things that were involved in that, but Daniel was a young man. He was certainly a teenager. He was separated from his parents. He was separated from his home, his culture, all that he knew, all that was familiar. And yet Daniel made the decision that he would continue to walk with God and to be obedient to what he knew was right. Can I challenge you this morning in the world that we live in with all of its pressures, with all of the pressure pushing back against us, and against the ways that God has commanded us to live, to resolve in your heart that you will be obedient, that you will do what is right. My friends, as a church, that is what God has called us to do, to live in obedience. But we must resolve to do so. Make the choice to do what's right.